So one method that I've come up with is to go into the corridors, and I'm going to set up a template. Now I've preset this, so I'm just going to double click on that to make it active, which it is. I'm going to create a stripping component. So I'm going to add new component, overlay stripping. I'm going to give this a sensible name. I'm going to pick a feature. I'm using the grading. I have a topsoil component there or feature. Now what I've done is I've actually gone in and into the element template, and I've created this as a construction class rather than primary, and you'll see why I've done this later on. So I really need to create a new feature definition for this component. But we've called it TC underscore topsoil. I'm going to follow the surface. I'm going to add a depth. I'm going to strip out a 100 mil. It's a stripping component, and I've already set one of these up, so I'm going to give it a parametric constraint of topsoil strip should I want to change these values or change the values of it along the scheme. Now, for the bottom of the pavement, I only need 2 points. I'm just running straight from left to right there, and I'll finish. I'm going to come and put these up on the right-hand side now for my batter slopes. Again, same information, it's a stripping component. Give it a depth. And then I come from the hinge up to the top of the cut slope there and finish, and then one more. And I'm going to come from the hinge again down to the fill slope. Right click, finish. Okay, one more thing now is I need to make the cut and the fill slope parents of my stripping component. So I'm just going to double click on the topsoil strip there. We'll select a parent component, which is the cut slope, apply, and I'm going to repeat this on the right-hand side there for the fill. So there's the topsoil. Again, we'll make the parent the fill component, and we'll hit apply, and we'll close. So let's test this. We'll draw, and you can see there is the topsoil strip. So we're looking pretty good there. So I'll come out of this, we'll save the template, and we'll close, and then we'll come and update this. I've already run this once, so I'm just going to update the corridor and synchronize it with the template. And we can see there it is on the right-hand side in the 3D view. I've also got this set up now in the cross-section window, and you can see as we come along, we've got the topsoil strip shown there. Now, obviously, in the 3D view, it can get a little bit confusing, and this is why I made the component a construction class. Because if I just come in here now and I'll just turn off constructions, and we can now see the normal, what we'd expect to see in that isometric view. But there's the topsoil strip. Again, if I just keep going, we should get into a fill eventually. We'll display the cut and fill graphics. I'll just change the exaggeration to 2. And again, if we just window in, you can see that there's my cut. We'll come back a few, and we can see both the cut and the fill and the topsoil strip. So again, remember, when we're looking at volumes, we'll have to remove the topsoil component from the cut volumes.